In this video today, I'll show you guys how to calculate the vessel's heel due to turning. So we'll take up an example, but I'll also explain the whole thing in theory as well. So here the question is that a ship turns to port in a circle of radius 100 meters at a speed of 15 knots. The GM of the vessel is 0.67 meters and BG is 1 meter. I'll show you what BG is as well as what GM is. If G is equal to 9.81 meters per second square, and this is the acceleration, G stands for acceleration, and 1 knot is equal to 1852 kilometers per hour, find the heel due to turning. Alright, this is the question, but before I get into the solution, I want you to understand what happens when a vessel starts to turn and why does it develop a heel. So if you see this figure here, you can see that this is a vessel which is actually heeling onto one side, and here you can see how the center of the buoyancy has shifted due to the heel. The center of the buoyancy is shown by the letter B, and this has shifted. Now the displacement of the vessel W is acting downwards, and so is the center of the gravity, and the vessel's buoyancy is equal and opposite to the vessel's displacement acting downwards. Alright, now what happens when a body moves in a circular path? There is an acceleration towards the center, which equals to the square of the velocity of the body divided by the radius of the circular path. So this is how it is denoted as. Alright, square of the velocity of the body divided by the circle of the radius. Now therefore, the force that is required to produce this acceleration is called a centripetal force. Now you can see the centripetal force I have shown you here in the diagram. This is equal to mv square by r, where m is the mass of the body. Now in the case of a ship turning in a circle, the centripetal force is produced by the water acting on the side of the ship away from the center of the turn. The force is considered to act at the center of lateral resistance, which in this case is the centroid of the underwater area of the ship's side away from the center of the turn. The centroid of this area is considered to be at the level of the center of buoyancy. For equilibrium, there must be an equal and opposing force called the centrifugal force that you see here. And this force is considered to act at the center of the mass, which is the center of the gravity. Alright, so when a ship's rudder is put over to port, for example, the forces on the rudder itself will cause the ship to develop a small angle of heel initially to port. However, the underwater form of the ship and the centrifugal force on it will cause the ship to heel to starboard. Now in this situation, the heel to starboard will always be greater than the heel to port. Consequently, for port rudder helm, the final angle of the heel due to turning will be to starboard or vice versa. So if the vessel was turning to starboard, the heel would be to port. Alright, so this is the theory behind it, and I'll show you how to solve this now. Alright, so here the ship speed in meters per second is 15 multiplied by 1852 divided by 3600. So because it's 15 knots, so we are converting it into meters per second. So this is 15 knots multiplied by, because 1 knot equals 1852 meters, and divided by 3600, which is seconds in 1 hour. So 3600 seconds in 1 hour. So therefore, we are converting the ship speed from knots to meters per second. This is what we are doing here. So therefore, the velocity of the ship will now in meters per second be equal to 7.72 meters per second. The formula here of calculating angle of heel is, when the vessel is turning, is tan theta, where theta is heel, equals square of the velocity, which is v square, multiplied by bg, that is the distance between the center of the buoyancy and the center of the gravity. The value is given to us in the question as 1 meter. Then it's g, which is acceleration. As I told you, the vessel will suffer from acceleration when it will start turning. G's value is given in the question as well. R is the radius of the turn given to us in the question as well, and GM is of course the distance between the center of the gravity and the vessel's metacenter, as you can see in the diagram. That is given in the value in the question as well. So all we have to do is just basically put in the values in the formula. So we squared the velocity multiplied by the BG, which is 1, divided by 9.81, which is G, 100 meters, which is the radius of the turn, and GM, which is 0.67. Once you get that, you get tan theta equals 0.0907. Take tan to the other side. So tan theta will be equal to this. So when tan goes to the other side, becomes tan inverse. Tan inverse of the value will give you the value of angle of field, which is equal to 5 degrees 11 minutes, and it will be to starboard, because like I told you or explained to you before, when the vessel turns to port, the heel is always on the opposite side, and vice versa. So when the vessel is turning to port, the vessel will heel to starboard due to centrifugal forces only. Now there will be this angle of heel will be slightly smaller in practice, because there will be small angle of heel to port as well. So the resultant angle of heel will be still to starboard, but of a slightly lesser value than 5 degrees 11 minutes, because some heel will also develop in the port side, and that will kind of reduce the heel to starboard, but by a degree or so. Alright, that's pretty much it. So if you are ever asked about vessels heeling or ships heeling due to turning, this is the theory and the example of calculation behind it. Thanks guys, bye for now.